Okay, today we are going to explain a simple problem for a determination of residential status of an individual. Okay, this is a simple problem. This is very helpful for understanding of theory. Right, look at that. Mr. X is of an Indian citizen. First time he went to America on 1-1-2020. Determine his residency status for the assessment year 2020-21. Okay, determine his residential status. Okay, for the assessment year 2020-21. Mr. X is an Indian citizen. Is an Indian citizen. Okay. Indian citizen. First time he went to America on, when he went to America on 1-1-2020. First time he went to America on 1-1-2020. Determine his residential status for the assessment year 2020-2021. So assessment year 2020-2021. Okay, the residential status of an individual, the determination of residential status of an individual is always depends on number of days stay in India in the previous year. In the previous year. Okay, look at the problem it is. Answer it is, the assessment year 2020-2021. Assessment year 2020-21, for the assessment year 2020-21, previous year is 2019-2020. Once again, for the assessment year 2020-2021, previous year is 2019-2020. Is it right? So then we should calculate number of days stay in India, number of days stay in India in the previous year 2019-2020. That's why, look at this, Mr. X, number of days stay in India for the previous year 2019-2020, date is 1-4-2019 to 31st 3-2020. Okay. Mr. X, number of days stay in India. Number of days stay in India, it is the most important. In the previous year, 2019-2020. The date of 2019-2020 is 1-4-2019 to 31st 3-2020. Right. When he went to America? 1-1-2020 he went to America. Okay. Up to that period he available in India. No problem. Okay. So 2019-2020 previous year, the date is 1-4-2019, 31st 3-2020. Right. When he went to America, 1-1-2020. Okay, right. In April 2019, he available in India. Number of days stay in India, 30 days. May, 31 days. June, 30 days. July, 31 days. August 31 days, September 30 days, October 31 days, November 30 days, December 31 days. Okay, after that he went to America 1-1-2020. That's why he is not number of days stay in India in January nil, February nil, March nil. So the total number of days stay in India in the previous year is 275 days. How many days here? 275 days. Once again, he went to America 1/1/2020. Then you have to be find out number of days stay in India in the previous year of 2019-2020. 2019-2020 date is 1/4/2019 to 31/3/2020. So we have to be calculate number of days stay in India in between the period. So that's why he first time he went to America 1/1/2020. Up to the date he available in India, he stay in India. Mr. X stay in India, no problem at all. So on April 2019, he available in India 30 days. 2019 May, 31 days available in India. June, 30 days. July, 31 days. August, 31 days. September, 30 days. October, 31 days. November, 30 days. December, 31 days. January, 30 nil. Because why? He went to America on 1/1/2020. So, January, nil. February, nil. March, nil. So, the total number of days stay in India in the previous year 2019-2020 is equal to 275 days. On the basis of this information, we have to be determine the residential status of X. Okay, let them see now. There are two basic conditions and two additional conditions is there for determination of residential status of X. Right, what are the basic conditions? It is basic conditions. First one, stay in India for 182 days or more days in the previous year. This is the first basic condition. Yes, this condition is satisfied by the X. Because why? Number of days stay in India 275 days. But the first basic condition is stay in India 182 days more in the previous year. Minimum days stay in India in the previous year only 182 days. So, but the X is stay in India, number of days stay in India 275 days. That's why the X satisfies first condition in basic condition, no problem at all. Next one, second basic condition, what is that? Stay in India for 60 days in previous year. The previous year means year 2019-2020, right? Stay in India for 60 days. Yes, he is available in previous year 275 days. But here the condition is stay in India for 60 days. Yes, he is available 275 days. So this condition is satisfied. Some of part of the condition. Next one, or more in the previous year plus 365 days more in 4 years preceding the previous year. Another condition is there in two. Okay, first, stay in India 60 days. Yes, stay in India for 60 days or more in the previous year. Yes, he is number of days stay in India in the previous year 275 days. That means this condition is satisfied. In another part of this condition, plus 365 days or more in the four previous preceding the previous year. So look at that one. This is the previous year. This is the previous year 2019-2020. The condition is asked for the previous year preceding to the four previous years. Preceding to the four previous years. This is the previous year. What is the meaning? Four previous preceding to the previous year. So previous it is that. Preceding to the four previous year means this one is that. 2015-2016, 2016-2017, 2017-2018, 2018-2019. Number of days stay in India. 365 days. Yes, he is available in India in the year of 2015 2016 2017 2017 2018 2018 2019. He is available in India because why? First time he went to America 1-1-2020, up to the date he available in India. That's why the 365 days are more in four previous preceding the previous years he available in India. So the more of 365 days available in India and 60 days or more days his number of days stay in India. So this condition is also satisfied by X. Next one, additional conditions. Resident in India for 2 out of 10 previous preceding the previous years. So resident in India for two years out of ten previous preceding the previous years. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All 365 days for this year is available in India. He is the resident for the 2 years preceding to the previous year of 10 years. Because first time he went to America, 1-1-2020, up to the date, he available in India. That's why the first condition in basic condition satisfied by the X. Once again, resident in India for 2 years out of 10 previous preceding the previous years. Previous year preceding the 10 previous years. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 previous years. He must be resident at least 2 years. Yes. He is the resident 10 years preceding to the previous year. That's why this condition is also be satisfied by the X. Next one. Stay in India 730 days more during the 7 previous years preceding the previous years. In 7 years, 730 days. In 7 years, 730 days. Yes, in 7 years previous to the preceding to the previous year, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is the 7. Number of days required only 730 days, but he is available more than of 730 days. So this condition is also be satisfied by X. So SSC means individual satisfied. Individual of X satisfy two conditions in basic conditions and two conditions in additional conditions. That's why the residential status of X for the previous year 2019-2020 is to be treated as resident and ordinary resident. Okay, so the residential status of an SSC is always depends on number of days stay in India. The residential status of an individual not to be depends on his citizenship. This is the example for that. So once again, Mr. X is an Indian citizen. First time he went to America on 1-1-2020. Determine his residential status for the assessment year 2020-21. Okay, so number of days stay in India in the previous year 275 days. Number of days stay in India in the previous year of 2019-2020 275 days. Okay, what is the conditions it is? First condition, basic conditions. In first condition, stay in India for 182 days or more days in the previous year. Yes, number of days stay in India by the X in the year of previous year 2019-2020 is 275 days. So, Mr. X satisfies this condition. Next one, stay in India for 60 days or more in the previous year. Yes, Mr. X stay in India 275 days. The more than the 60 days available in India. Right? And plus 365 days or more in 4 years preceding more four previous preceding the previous years. Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4 number of days, 365 days or more days. Yes, 365 days or more days is available in India. That's why he satisfies second condition in basic conditions. Next one, additional conditions. Resident in India for 2 years, resident in India for 2 years out of 10 previous preceding the previous years. Resident in India 2 years out of 10 previous preceding the previous years. So he first time went to America on 1-1-2020. So he is the resident, 2 years resident out of 10 previous years preceding to the previous, out of 10 preceding to the previous years. Next one, stay in India 730 days more during the 7 previous years preceding the previous years. Yes, he available 730 days or more days in 7 previous years preceding the previous years. So here the Mr. X satisfies 2 conditions in basic conditions, 2 conditions in additional conditions. If an individual satisfies 2 conditions in basic conditions and 2 conditions in additional conditions, then the residential status of an SSC is to be treated as resident and ordinary resident. So the assessment, the residency status of an SSC for 2019 to 2020 previous year is resident and ordinary resident. Okay, another problem. Problem for determination of residential status of an individual, exercise 2. What is residential status of Mr. Y for the year, assessment year 2019-2021? Who was in India as follows? That means number of days stay in India. Already calculated, need not to be calculated separately or monthly wise year. 2019-2020, 182 days. 2018-2019, 55 days. And 2017-2018, 28 days. Okay, right. In the year of 2019-2020, that means this is the previous year. This is the most important for us. Year, 182 days. Next one, 2018-2019, 55 days. 2017-2018, 28 days. Right. This is the days, number of days stay in India by Mr. Y. Right. For the calculation of or for the determination of residential status of an SSC, for the assessment year 2019-2020, let them see now number of days stay in India in the previous year. Okay, number of days stay in India in the previous year, 182 days. Okay, What is the first condition in basic conditions? First one, stay in India for 182 days or more. Stay in India 182 days or more in the previous year. In the previous year. Previous year means 2019-2020. Mr. Y, number of days stay in India, 182 days. Okay, that's why Mr. Y satisfies first condition in basic condition. Second condition, stay in India for 60 days, stay in India for 60 days, yes, he is available 182 days. So, the part A in first, second condition satisfies. Stay in India for 60 days or more in the previous year. Yes, it's satisfied. But then 365 days or more in the previous, preceding the previous years. So what about the situation is 2019-2020. Okay, four preceding years of previous year, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2018-2019, he only available 55 days in 2018-2019. 2017-2018, only available 28 days. So, remaining days not available in India. Remaining years not available in India. So, number of days available only 83 days. Only 83 days. In four previous years preceding the previous year. Four previous years preceding the previous year, Mr. Y available only 83 days. But here, how many days asked as per condition? 365 days. So, assessee not satisfied second condition in basic conditions. Next one, additional conditions. Resident in India for 2 years out of 10 previous preceding the previous year. Okay. For previous year, 10 previous year must be he resident 2 years. No, this condition is not satisfied by the why? Because he is not a resident. For 2 years out of 10 previous preceding to the previous year. Next one, stay in India 730 days more during the 7 previous years preceding the previous year. Previous year preceding to the 7 previous years, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, up to this. He must be in India, how many days? 730 days, but he is available only 83 days. So, the second condition in additional condition not satisfied by why? Once again, what is residential status of Mr. Y for the assessment year 2020-2021? Who was in India as follows? Previous year presence in India. 2019-2020 available 182 days. 2018-2019 55 days. 2017-2018 28 days. The first condition in basic condition, stay in India for 182 days more in the previous year. Yes, the assessee satisfied first condition in basic condition because he is available in the previous year 182 days. That's why Mr. Y satisfied first condition in basic condition. Next, what about the situation in second condition? Stay in India 60 days or more days in the previous year. Yes, assessee available in the previous year 182 days, that's why this condition is satisfied. But in the part of second condition of basic condition, 365 days more in the four previous preceding the previous years. How many days wanted? 365 days. But previous year preceding to the four previous years, SSC only available in India 83 days. But the condition is required 365 days. So totally SSC not satisfied second condition in basic conditions. Next, additional condition. Resident, SSC must be resident at least 2 years. At least 2 years out of 10 previous preceding the previous years. 10 previous preceding to the previous year. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. SSC is not a resident. 2 years out of 10 preceding to the previous year. That's why this condition is not satisfied by Mr. Y. Next one, stay in India 730 days more during the seven previous preceding the previous years. How many days? 730 days more during the seven previous years preceding the previous years. How many days required in 7 years preceding to the previous year? 730 days. Previous year preceding to the seven previous years. One previous year 2019-2020. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. How many days required as per condition? 730 days. But SSC is available only 83 days. So, Mr. X, Mr. Y not satisfied. This condition is also. Then what is the meaning of that? Mr. Y satisfies only one condition in basic condition. Mr. Y not satisfied additional condition, the two additional conditions. When an individual satisfies only one condition in basic conditions, none of additional conditions, then the residential status of an individual is to be treated as resident but not ordinary resident. So the residential status of Mr. Y for the assessment year 2020-2021 is to be treated as resident but not ordinary resident. Because why? He satisfies only one condition in basic condition. Okay. Thank you. Exercise problem 3. Mr. Ramesh first time came to India on 1-1-2019 and went to America on 31-10-2019. Determine his residential status of Mr. Ramesh for the assessment year 2019-2021. Okay, let them see now. Number of days stay in India in the previous year of 2019-2020 of Mr. Ramesh. Okay, number of days stay in India by Mr. Ramesh for the previous year 2019-2021. The date of previous year 2019-2020, 1-4-2019 to 31-3-2020, you know very well. So first time he came to India 1-7-2019. He not available in June. So number of days stay in India nil. May nil. June nil. Okay. First time he came to India 1-7-2019. Up to he live in other countries. Right. So on 7 he available in India. So July 31st days. Next one, went to America 31-10-2019. That's why 31 days available in India. Okay, 30 days available in India. Okay, 31 days available in India. Okay, he went to America as on 31st 10 2019. That's why he not available in India in November nil, December nil, January nil, next one February nil, next one March nil. So number of days stay in India only 123 days in the previous year. Once again, Mr. Ramesh first time came to India. Before the date, he is not available in India. Before that date, okay, he available outside in India. That's why Mr. Ramesh first time came to India 1-7-2019, and he went to America 31st 10 2019. Only 4 months stay in India. Okay, determine his residency status of Mr. Ramesh for the year 2020-2021. Right, number of days stay in India by Mr. Ramesh for the previous year 2019-2020. So assessment year, for the assessment year 2020-2021, previous year is 2019-2020. The date of previous year is 1-4-2019 to 31st 3 2020. So let us see now how many days available in between the period. First, April nil, May nil, June nil, July. First time he came to India 1-7-2019. That's why 31 days available in India. September 31 days available in India. August 31 days available in India. September 30 days available in India. October 31 days available in India. He went to America on 31st 10 2019, na? So he not available in November, December, January, February. So the total number of days available in India, Mr. Ramesh, is 123 days only in the previous year 2019-2020. Let them see now, for determination of his residential status, we have to be check the basic conditions and additional conditions as usual. What is the first basic condition? Stay in India for 182 days more in the previous year. But Ramesh available in India only 123 days. So Mr. Ramesh not satisfied first condition in basic condition, and stay in India for 60 days or more in the previous year. Yes, this some of the part of second condition is satisfied, 60 or more days, but he stay in India 123 days, but some part in second condition he satisfied. But in another part in second condition, 365 days or more in preceding the previous years. But Ramesh is not available. First time he came to India, na? So before 10 years preceding to the previous years, he not available in India. Because first time he came to India 1-7-2019. That's why Mr. Ramesh not satisfied second condition in basic conditions. Whenever one individual not satisfied two basic conditions, then need not to be checked the additional conditions. Because the individual not satisfied two conditions in basic conditions. So, if an individual not satisfies two conditions in basic conditions, then the residential status of an individual is to be considered as non-resident. So, the residential status of Mr. Ramesh for the previous year is non-resident. Because why? He does not satisfy two basic conditions. So that's why the residential status of Mr. Ramesh is to be treated as non-resident. Okay, thank you very much.